Thanks for tuning in to the final episode of 575 Ounces, the most consistent cricket show on the planet ever. Consistent in getting all our predictions wrong. How you ask? Siddhant Thani, Vaibhav Raghunandan and Arjun Pandit. In our first episode, we said that 500 ka aakda toda jayega is World Cup. Mein. Kya hua, bhai?
कुछ नहीं हुआ भाई
कुछ नहीं 250 नहीं बन रहे थे
250 नहीं ये ऑलमोस्ट 400 बन गए थे
सर प्लीज एक मुकाबले में अफगानिस्तान के खिलाफ विद इंग्लैंड ओके देन केम द थर्ड एपिसोड आफ्टर इंडिया पाकिस्तान वेयर वी सेड इंडिया पाक राइवलरी डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट व्हिच इज करेक्ट इन सम वे ऑर द अदर बट वी आल्सो सेड दैट पाकिस्तान डजंट हैव एनी चांस ऑफ मेकिंग इट फार इन दिस वर्ल्ड कप क्या हुआ उसमें
They almost made the semi-finals.
So wrong again. Then came, of course, the episode after that. Where
Although again, there's no like prizes for going home. I mean, almost se kya hota hai?
So, yehi
wala logic hai na? Uske baad,
India versus Afghanistan ka humne preview kaha, jahan humne kaha ki Afghanistan is all over the place. They maybe do not deserve to be in the top 10 of the world. And then what happened? Afghanistan ran India close into the final over. Afghanistan ran Pakistan close to the final over.
There's no prizes for losing a game, bro.
I still feel we got it wrong. We were wrong. Okay, then came the preview for India versus England in the league phase. And there we said, India will win. India will win. And then kya hua?
India didn't want to win.
England won.
Batting practice. That was next.
Batting practice. That day. And then live came the best next. One. Yeah, the best one was this one. Best. That we said, ki semi-final jo hoga, it'll be India versus England. And then it'll be Australia taking on New Zealand. Semi-finals, kya khele gaye?
India versus New Zealand.
Australia, England.
But then came the only prediction which has been correct
Absolutely.
In this entire series of episodes that we've been getting it wrong. The man on our left.
The hipster.
The hipster. The wise one.
The only one who actually follows cricket.
The only one who actually follows cricket had called
England, New Zealand.
Aye, that's the way to go.
So, first and foremost. Sir, आपने ये क्या देखकर आपने ये ऐसी बात बोली जो आपके सामने इतने वरिष्ठ किस्म के पत्रकार थे जो क्रिकेट को इतना फॉलो करते हैं आपने ये क्या तिगड़ा लगाया जो आपने ये सही कॉल किया
Sir, I think you guys got too much into the specifics of the situation. And I think you also lost track of the multiple other variables that go into a cricket game.
So, आप बता दो सर क्योंकि इसके आगे भी कुछ बोलना
well,
चाहिए.
I mean,
आप expect
did you think that New Zealand's midfield was stronger?
क्योंकि आपने इतना क्रिकेट जो खेला है, आप जो बाहर गली में खेलते हैं, रणजी में खेलते हैं, डियोदर ट्रॉफी में खेलते हैं, दुलीप में खेलते हैं, ये क्या वेरिएबल हमने मिस कर दिया यहाँ पे जो आपने नहीं किया?
Actually, समय ठीक चल रहा है.
चलो ठीक है बस.
All the planets are aligned.
Everything is aligned and we believe in that. And planets have been aligned for England and New Zealand because the final of the World Cup come the 14th of July will be played between these two teams which means come the 14th of July one new team will be walking away with the
First
World
time
Cup.
Winners.
First time ever. England of course making the final after 1992. New Zealand making the final after the last edition that being in 2015 where they lost to Australia. So of course the build up to that big game is the topic of our discussion on 575 ounces. First and foremost, whenever I was talking to people and you know, you talk about rivalries, England and New Zealand has always been regarded as a very friendly rivalry.
New Zealand's rivalry with everyone is fairly friendly. Yeah.
Fairly friendly, I agree. Both the captains get along with each other, Owen Morgan, Kane Williamson. And keeping that in mind, it would be fair to say that it won't be a very tense and cagey affair. Like you generally, you know, you the way you sort of, you know.
Oh, you mean like, yeah.
Yeah, it won't be that kind of, like if it would have been a Australia-England, if it would have been a India versus England or an India versus Australia, the intensity and all that's happening around it would have sortly, you know, would have, of course, added up. Yahan pe, I don't think that is going to happen. Also, probably because England has always been earmarked to win this World Cup. And they've sort of had that belief in themselves ever since they decided to change direction after the 2015 World Cup. So, थोड़ा मजा आएगा इस मुकाबले में क्योंकि वो सब बाहर की चीजें नहीं देखने को मिलेंगी. So, you'll just see, of course, pure athleticism and you know, whoever's very good at whatever they do, that is going to be talking.
That's true. There's not going to be, I mean, that the external factor of psychological warfare and this and that and all kinds of history, all that is not going to play a part. I think it's just going to be a game of cricket, which is ideally what you want. Final to be like, perhaps.
Yeah, and also the fact that
not at all, I guess. I mean, not when you have 8 hours to watch it, and I think.
Nee, bhai, I kind of agree with that. Yeah,
the thing that makes cricket so I guess so much of a draw for so many of us is that there's so much other storytelling going on around it.
And yeah, but yeah, you don't want the Bahar ka storytelling to have an impact on what's happening on the field, na? That's my point. I said if that day Bolt is swinging the ball like mad and he gets the better of Jason Roy, then that's, you know, on merit he's got the better of Jason Roy. But all that Bahar ka spiel that follows England, ki, you know,
or
it's
any
coming
of these
home
big
and
teams, like in all fairness, like that's perhaps one of the reasons why New Zealand consistently go under the radar and do really well, because they don't have this Bahar ka storyline at any point of time with anyone. Hmm. Whether they play India, okay, they play Australia, there's a certain amount of rivalry which is actually not generated because of cricket. It's generated because of rugby, it's generated because of that Tasman geographical rivalry.
Derby.
Yeah, Tasman Derby, and it's, you can see that the New Zealanders are fairly like...
Also, it's not, it's never considered nice to be the end of the world if you lost a game in New Zealand, you know. India, mein, I was reading the report that because their flights have not yet been booked, they've been holed up in the rooms since they've lost that semi-final, you know.
In the sense that they haven't moved around.
No, it's not that you can't get out, they're just not coming out because wo jo jhatka pada hai, still haven't been, you know, able to get over it. Waisa, I think New Zealand mein hai nahi. If you look, both the captains, extremely calm.
Hmm.
In body language, right? They don't let too many things phase them out. I was reading something on Owen Morgan and the team that when they decided to flip the switch to how England approaches cricket, which was post the 2015 World Cup, or in fact, it was during the 2015 World Cup, during one of those losses, I think to Bangladesh or something, where they said, look, we need to flip the switch. And just the fact that it's easier said than done. You know, we've changed our approach. But the amount of things you had to change in order to have that approach, the amount of people you had to blindly trust and follow the process, and all of that has come together to, you know, get them
to
where they are.
Can I ask what the
right
old
now.
Approach was and what the new approach is? Or is it
the old approach, the old approach was basically that, you know, how ODI cricket was basically being played in the past, where, you know, you have your batsmen who will come in, they won't go on too aggressive.
It was a very traditional...
You play till deep, right? You have your six batsmen, you have your four bowlers, you have that one all-rounder in there. Yahan pe they said, in 50-over format, we can't have that. We want people who bat till 8-9. So if you're a bowler, that doesn't mean you can't come in there and contribute with the runs. The approach which is being started by a Jason Roy and a Johnny Bairstow up top, nowhere down the order, irrespective of when you lose the wicket, should someone, of course, you play according to the situation, but once you've gotten through the situation, you play with that approach of taking on the bowlers. So you're always trying to, you know, get one up on the bowlers rather than them, of course, coming in and you're holding back and you're holding back and you're holding back and letting the pressure build up.
Build up.
They identified their players, man. Yeah, I honestly feel why this final is going to be fun is because you've got Archer Wokes, two zipping good fast bowlers. On the other hand, you've got Henry, you've got Bolt,
and
you've got
Ferguson.
So that for me makes it an interesting contest, man. And to say that this, a lot of people are saying this World Cup is not going to be an interesting one, the bat is going to overpower the ball, hasn't been the case at all.
I suppose this, all the chatter about why World Cup is happening in England in the first place, this is why.
Because
probably.
Because they don't really have a summer.
Yeah. The conditions are such that it and
it brings
and of
everyone
course,
in,
like,
yeah.
And even for India, I mean, if you look at, yeah, sure, Rohit Sharma had a cracker of a tournament. But like it was the bowling that was at the forefront of how India were playing, and perhaps if we had in the semi-finals won that toss, things the situation would have been reversed.
Well anyway, like
no, yeah, we bowled well. Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
If we had set a target, I think given that the bowlers were on the ascendancy in this tournament, the guy should have shown. I mean, he lost the toss, so there was nothing much he could do.
How do you guys see this game playing out, man? England versus New Zealand.
Oh, is this like a predictor
again? So
no,
no,
I don't know if it's a predictor.
You guys might as well not bother.
I'm going to go on a wing and I'm going to say that England are going to win via the DLS method.
Wow. I think New Zealand are going to take it.
I think New Zealand is in a bit of an issue. England goes in as favourite because their openers have not been doing anything, man. Williamson has always been coming out to bat in the second or third over.
Always.
And even after that, there are not too many batsmen who have been holding fort.
I mean, Martin Guptill's greatest moments of the World Cup have all got to do with fielding.
Yeah,
some
man.
Spectacular catches and a spectacular run out.
And how many people have been saying Martin Guptill is coming good? Now Martin Guptill is ready to play a beginnings. Final aa gaya hai. Abhi tak Martin Guptill has not done anything in the World Cup. And the truth be told, they don't have another batsman of Guptill's quality. Otherwise, Guptill would have been out a long time back. You know, because you've got Colin Munro there, who's already been dropped. Now you've put Henry Nichols over there, who also was very slow versus India, but sort of the approach helped because those 20-30 runs made a big difference.
Yeah. I mean, I must admit, I was making a lot of fun of Kane Williamson, Ross Taylor and Henry Nichols.
They assessed the situation, man.
Yeah, I know. I was making a lot of fun of them for forgetting that this was a one-day match and going the test route, but seems to have made...
That made the difference, to be honest.
I also really liked the fact that the game was split over 2 days.
I really like that. I think a two-day international is the perfect way to go
really?
About this.
Guys, ICC, so if you're thinking of new format...
I know you guys are watching this show.
No, but I'm dragging this back to the final, yeah, because while on the one hand, New Zealand is very frail as far as batting is concerned, England, even if you get past Johnny Bairstow and Jason Roy, who've been in... They've hit four... opening century stands, man, in six innings.
I think Joe
six
Root
innings,
has
that's a World Cup record, yeah. So I'm saying even if you get past them, then you have Joe Root, then
exactly.
You have Morgan, then you have Stokes, then you have Butler, and then there is of course Chris Wokes who can bat.
Then
there's Archer who can bat.
Yeah.
I mean Archer can come in and make those 50.
Yeah, I don't see this like. I mean, I think England should be getting their first World Cup.
I honestly hope England, whoever wins the toss, puts England bats first. England bats first, you don't have that pressure of defending a total. And then Henry and Bolt and, you know, Ferguson come in with that raw pace and just intimidate them, man, with that pace. Because you've got that pace. So Ferguson is clocking close to 150, man.
And he has such a lazy action. Like, I'm sorry, but he does not look like he should be clocking 150. Like, he does not look like Brett Lee or Shoaib Akhtar or even Mitchell Starc. You know, those guys, when they're coming, steaming in, you can feel ki, oh, yep, this is going to be fast. Like, he has such a... tennis ball action.
Yeah, and while we're talking about the pacers, man, I think the... Sir, I'm bored. I'm
about to leave the building.
Spinners ki baat karni padegi, yaar.
Yeah, I think...
Adil Rashid, yaar.
So he really understands leg spin, man.
No, I'll tell you how there are two really solid spinners on either side, man. Because Adil Rashid, expensive, but he started getting the wickets. Santana, not getting too many wickets, but maintains the pressure by
giving too many
runs.
Santana is basically like, as soon as Vettori retired, I think they went into the nearest school and they found the guy who was teaching geography and said, hey, left arm spin, yes, here you go.
He's been really good, man.
He's outstanding. I love these.
See, at least I get the references.
Yeah, see, you get it.
Itna bhi bura nahi hai.
These bespectacled left arm, slow left arm New Zealanders are lovely. I love them.
Sir, because you're the only one who's got our predictions correct so far.
New Zealand, sir.
New Zealand.
100%. We started with anyone but England and we're sticking to anyone but England.
Yeah, unfortunately, I can't stick to anyone but England because this is just now like...
Oh, you're being objective, is it?
Yeah, you know, I'm being objective. Yes. I think England
Sir,
is too strong.
Objectivity
yeah.
or not, if you are betting people, you listen to me. Baki, aap log dekh lijiye.
Yes,
experts
be real, guys. Like, be real.
Okay, so fine. So, let
Moving
it be
on
record. England, New Zealand.
England via DLS.
England still, na, but at the end of the day.
DLS kese, yaar, do din hai.
Okay, friends, this is the final ki baat ho gayi.
But वैसे I'll be watching the Wimbledon final that day.
Thank you so much for validating the show, sir, for coming on the show and talking about cricket. Yeah. We search so hard to find the right kind of guests to come and talk cricket.
Absolutely.
There's so much passion.
And it's always lovely when a guy comes on a cricket show and says that, you know what, I'm going to watch Wimbledon final.
Theek hai, sir, aap se hi shuru karta hu. The World Cup
Lewis
has gone
Hamilton
by.
Lewis Hamilton is in two minds about whether to race the race or to watch the cricket or to watch the tennis.
Fair enough.
No, so, matlab, main kya
fair enough.
Main kya
at all.
Main kya cheez.
Sir, 40-45 din ka World Cup khatam hone ko aa raha hai.
Ji.
And field ki to baatein ho gayi hain. Of course, aapke saamne dikh raha hai who's in the final. But as regards to what's happening outside the field, there was so much as well, right?
Yeah.
As comes with any big world tournament.
As comes with anything that goes on for 45 days.
45 days, man. So, for you, some of the highlights for what's happened outside of the field over this last 45, 50 days?
Yeah, I feel like there was a few sort of conversations that were generated, quite pertinent conversations to some extent. The first was Michael Holding. In the context of, yeah, for sure.
We need more people like him.
Yeah.
Easier said than that. Done, but.
Much easier said than done.
Yeah.
For sure. I don't know what his contract.
At least tell us what the thing was then.
No, essentially, it's about how commentary is done, what the purpose of those commentators are, or is.
Call it as it is.
Yeah. And also bring insight into the game, because you're not just some guy who's a broadcaster or a presenter, right? You have a wealth of knowledge and experience.
Thanks.
And stories and all of that.
Thanks.
Not you. Not you, Michael.
I'm not, I'm you're not just a presenter.
No,
you have a wealth of stories and all to add.
So,
agreed.
I mean, you're not a presenter at all, in fact. Huh. Presenters are the guys whose faces are important. These are the guys in the comms box.
Yeah, they tow
a
certain line.
And you're not a PR
line.
Guy either, who's trying to promote.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, I mean, everyone in the world does it the same way, where the broadcaster pays the people that are doing the broadcast
come
to do their job.
Yeah.
Right? And they are all paying for rights. They're all rights holders who spend money on the rights. But that doesn't have to make it a PR exercise. You look at how commentary happens in the NBA, for example. They're having real conversations, not about this, not just about the sport, but how that impacts the world around it, how things are can develop, what's happening with the game at large. And when you have an 8-hour long game, that's fundamental to the conversation. Otherwise, what is the purpose of having commentary? Yaar, dikh toh sabko raha hai kya ho raha hai
field pe. What NBA has realized and what a lot of people don't realize is that when you have honest conversations, That in turn helps in popularizing the sport even more. Because a lot more people talk about it, a lot more people get involved in the conversation.
Yeah, the reason we get involved is because things are relatable, right? Either characters are relatable or stories are relatable or whatever, something that strikes some kind of a chord. Now, how are we going to find out those stories if all commentators are allowed to talk about it, what's happening there? Mm. How are we going to have these discussions around it? What is, otherwise... Hum jaise baith ke baat
kar rahe hain. Absolutely. Like the purpose of a commentator is also to spark a discussion. Like it's necessary to do that. And whether you agree with it or not or whatever, whichever way the you fall on the argument.
Spectrum, yeah.
It's...
Yeah, like, I can tell you... I was expecting ki itna jitna baatcheet hua, utna nahi hoga. So I was sort of pleasantly surprised that at least a few people, even if it's people on the fringes, right? They are not mainstream like the regular... Whether it's holding or the some of the associate nations that have come out very strongly to voice their opinions on being excluded from the
Which
tournament.
Is a good thing.
So of course it's a good thing. Yeah, I didn't expect it to happen
My
to the extent
with,
that it
with
did.
With holding is that if this was a holding of 20 years back, 30 years back, who just retired from his cricket and is now looking for a second innings in his life.
Hmm.
Would he have then come out and said something versus the ICC?
Yeah.
No, seriously, sir, you know, because that is
sorry.
The big dilemma
okay,
for
so
anyone speaking out.
So, no, can I
just say,
the people who are speaking, calm milega ya nahi? Kya baat kar
rahe hain? Sir, unko aap galat nahi bol sakte.
Aap agar Sachin Tendulkar hain, aapko kaam ki kya zarurat hai? Agar aap nahi bol sakte hain, to kaun bol sakta hai is duniya
mein? Sir, sabki want, sabki chahat alag hoti hai. Aapki chahat ye hogi, so you might be happy with that. Someone else might not be happy with that. They might want to stretch somewhere else.
Yeah.
See, my point is, a lot of people, when they're not talking about these things, you think these are everyone is having these conversations. Some are happening behind closed doors. Some are saying it right now, like holding, and people like us are talking about it.
Sure.
But the only thing is, when someone doesn't come out and say something, I think it is wrong to point fingers at them because we're not realizing what they might lose.
No. Okay, fair enough. I don't think that's the case, by the way. All I'm saying is
there is
something to lose. But if you're a person that himself or... Well, okay, the herselves are not included because they are not, they are in that position where they have to toe the line.
Yeah.
The women commentators, for sure. I get that. But if you're a guy who's retired after captaining India or England or Australia, you have millions in the bank. What is this sort of desperation to be included in this system that you can't speak? I mean, no one is asking you to like do sort of anti-corruption investigations. It's just basic.
Subjective choice, sir.
Of course, it's a subjective choice.
You might feel
it's really unfortunate
that
the
person who's being denied a job because he is too much of a mufat or is not towing the you know the bigger picture, that person might feel in a different way, na? Wo kahega yaar ki main okay. So here is a stint in commentary talking about all ICC big events 5 years, and here is this one comment which might just take this all away.
That's exactly what I'm saying. This is the problem. That's what it's become like, and that's what I'm saying. Like we don't see, know what will happen with holding.
I don't think anything's gonna happen. Holding.
I mean,
holding
doesn't matter. Himself. Like honestly speaking, like I don't think he cares.
But yeah, my simple point was that only that if you have achieved a certain
level
like massive, whether it's based on your economic situation or just what your stature is owing to what you've done in your previous career, you should owe it to yourself to have the integrity to speak the way you want to speak.
Absolutely.
Fair enough, yeah. But easier said than done. Yeah. There's another one.
As it is, professional broadcasters, and you know this, as well as anyone, the jobs for professional broadcasters or people who are journalists are getting fewer and fewer in the visual medium, because everyone wants only people with experience of having played the game at the highest level.
Hmm.
Right? So as it is, aap kisi aur ki naukri to le hi rahe hain.
Absolutely. I agree with that. Yeah.
To itna kya desperation hai, aapko member of parliament bhi banna hai, aapko commentary bhi karni hai, aapko restaurant bhi chalana hai.
Theek hai sir, this is a subjective thing. The next one that you're bringing up is the talk of the format. Right, yeah. And this is because, of course, after India lost the semi-final, and there are reports in the media that the coach of the Indian team is questioning the format. There are former players who are questioning the format, saying maybe we should have an IPL-style playoff. I'm like, what? How can I have an IPL-style? IPL ko World Cup ke saath aap compare hi kaise kar sakte ho?
Because India final mein nahi pahunch rahi hai, to usko ek aur mauka milna chahiye. Kya galat baat
hai? That is ridiculous, man.
In essence, like the World Cup is like that only, no? Like without India.
Sorry, by India I mean BCCI.
Sir, jo bhi ho, it is ridiculous to even suggest that maybe you should have a IPL style playoff. It is ridiculous to even mention IPL in the same breath as the World Cup. So the thing is, this whole playoff business is, please, yeah. I hope no one brings it up, man.
Absolutely.
If you bring it up, then just please don't make us judge you, man. Just please.
The next World Cup is being held in India. I feel like the new format for the World Cup, for the next World Cup, should be the big three plus a lottery pick. And they play each other for a month, and whoever wins the most number of games in that month wins the World
Cup. Here, put a placard, laga do, sarcastic, throughout the show.
I would be really excited to see a bigger World Cup.
Like, of course, yeah, absolutely. A World Cup, you mean?
Man, this conversation.
So yeah, we'll do it after 4 years.
But for you, the big thing outside the field, big talking point.
Outside the field, the big talking point is the big paunch of Lasith Malinga. I love that whole situation, the way it played out, where someone got a screen grab of Malinga walking topless in the dressing room, and immediately there was lots of comments like they usually are about he's unfit, he's not committed, this, that.
Body shaming.
Man, Lasith Malinga does not need abs to bowl the way he does, yeah.
See, I think that sort of brings about the point of experience is
also
more
like
important than anything else.
I think what it also brings about, perhaps, like, I don't know if I'm going too far saying this, that cricket is more about skill.
Yeah.
Than it is about...
And situational awareness.
Absolutely. Situational awareness, game IQ, just things like that are more...
Yeah, much more. Because see, what Malinga was doing, is he was outthinking the batsman. Yeah.
Always.
Usme, sir, mere ko paunch yahan paunchi hai, yahan paunchi hai, yahan paunchi hai. Usse kuch lena dena nahi hai. Usne slower one dal di, usne yorker dal di andar, usne cutter dal diya. Batsman soch raha hai, Malinga kya dalega? You know, and he's getting the better of them. Not saying that all cricketers should have a paunch. But of course, quality of Malinga, the experience of Malinga can't be achieved
also
by everyone.
Also, it's his body, I'm sure. And he's been now a pro for like...
more than a decade. Yeah, absolutely.
It's his body. I'm sure he's aware of what his limitations are and how, and he's
always
changing his game accordingly and how hard he can and cannot work off the field. I don't know.
And I read this piece, like a very good piece.
If he and his trainer are happy and his coach is happy...
And I read this piece about Malinga where the writers go on, he's visited Malinga and he goes to his village and everything, and then he does an interview with Malinga. And right at the end of that interview, they say goodbye to each other, and it's now going to be evening, there is no batsman in the nets, nothing. So he says that usually when you see this happening, then you see the cricketers go hit a gym or do some, you know, push-ups, warm, like do a little bit of physical work. What Malinga did was, he went and put two cones where he thought the batsman's feet would be. And he put like about 20 balls near his bowling mark and
just
started going and just bowling up.
Yeah, I know. Totally. Finally, no mention of this World Cup can be enough. I think no mention of any world sporting event will take place without what's happened in social media. And the stuff that's come out of social media. Of course, the first one has to be what happened after the India-Pak game. Where I thought those guys scripted it perfectly.
Yeah, that fast food promotion.
Yeah, the pizza, burger. I mean, that guy was hilarious, man. Even though he wasn't doing it.
You know who was hilarious? His friend.
मुझे पता चला कल रात ये लोग बर्गर खाते रहे हैं, कल रात ये लोग पिज़्ज़े खाते रहे हैं.
His friend was just too hilarious, man. वो कभी चश्मे निकाल रहा है, कभी आँख साफ कर
रहा है. Live trolling.
All these things were planned, and these kids, both these guys, they go to reputable colleges in England, yeah. Man. कहाँ पे? I think Oxford या कहीं पे पढ़ाई कर रहे थे ये लोग यार. So
not social bad. Media stars,
smart.
हमें लग रहा था इस्लामाबाद से ये लोग भाग के आए हैं यहाँ पे बकवास कर रहे हैं, पर ये
हमारी
तरह नहीं
है. सबकी पहुँच जाते हैं सुबह सुबह, लिख के आते हैं लोग.
लिख के आते हैं, सही बात है. ये सब पूरा planned था. एक और जो social media पे निकला था वो भारत के न्यूजीलैंड के साथ सेमीफाइनल से पहले एक न्यूज़ चैनल ने चलाया था. बड़ा बड़ा उनने यहाँ पे एक बैकग्राउंड में, जैसे हमारे पास बैकग्राउंड है ये, उनने डाला था मोदी जी जिताएंगे सेमीफाइनल. यार ये सर, आप न्यूज़ चैनल में आपने काम किया है
सर,
ये जब एंकर प्रोड्यूसर बैठ के सोचते हैं कि हमें जी एक डालना है, ये शर्म नहीं आती उनको बिल्कुल भी, या शर्म खो चुके हैं वो अपनी?
मैं जिस न्यूज़ चैनल में था उसकी तो बात कर ही नहीं सकते, बिकॉज उनकी जो फिलॉसफी थी उसके कारण तो बेचारों को ऑलमोस्ट बंद ही कर दिया
जी, हमने भी काम किया
तो क्या ही कहें उसके बारे में. बट या देयर सपोज्ड टू बी एन एडिटोरियल प्रोसेस, अपेरेंटली दीस गाइज थिंक दिस इज एन एडिटोरियल प्रोसेस, सो इट्स नॉट एन एंकर एंड प्रोड्यूसर डिसाइडिंग व्हाट गोज अप.
मेबी दे जस्ट थॉट दैट ही वाज अ बेटर नंबर 4 बैट्समैन, ही वुड हैव फील्ड.
ओह या, फॉर श्योर, फॉर श्योर. आई थिंक द डिबेट कंटिन्यूज.
Ridiculous, man. That was ridiculous. Then the other one was match ke mujrim kaun hai? Kohli, Rohit Sharma, ya Mahendra Singh Dhoni?
Who was responsible for India losing to New Zealand? The simple answer to that is
Modi ji bhi nahi the,
New Zealand.
Seriously, man. Ridiculous.
But like my favorite one of these from the after the loss is this one featuring, of course, the two, the king and the prince. Modi ji and Virat Kohli. It's two in one, double dhamaka. So producer sahab jara usko dal dijiyega.
Kya baat hai, kya baat hai.
Have some laughs.
Doston, to isi ke saath ant khatam hua hamara 575 ounces ka silsila. Agar hum iske baad aapne kabhi bhi 575 ounces nahi dekha, so then you can see the three people on your screen. They are to be blamed for it squarely, because you know, maybe we just didn't do the right things. Or if we get a lot of views, we get more than 5,000, 6,000 views, because that's how low our expectations are, then you never know, we might just start another 575 ounces.
I think it's been a successful World Cup, guys. I don't
know why you're being so... 575 ounces ki baat.
Maybe, or World Cup show hai yaar, toh World Cup successful hoga, toh hum bhi successful honge. I think, aur hum, ye humare market share ka statistic dalte hain yahan pe. 0.0000 something percent. The biggest sport in the world.
Any final comments, guys?
Yeah, it's been fun, guys. It's been fun. It's been really fun. I got to learn a great deal about this wonderful sport. And I got to make a lot of fun of a lot of rich and powerful people. So that's always good.
Wow. It's tough to follow up with something like that.
Okay. Let's just...
Should we end it then?
Put it to an end.
Okay, guys. This was the final episode of 575 Ounces. आंसू आ रहे हैं पर मैं दिखाना नहीं चाह रहा. फिर मिलेंगे या नहीं वो तो 6,000 व्यू के बाद ही पता चलेगा. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. इंग्लैंड, न्यूजीलैंड.